We've been hearing about avian influenza or bird flu. Why is WHO concerned about it? Who is at risk? And how can you protect yourself? Here to talk about it is Dr. Wenqing Zhang. Welcome, Wenqing. Talk to us about avian influenza and how it's affecting humans.
Avian influenza or bird flu is a disease in birds caused by a virus. Sometimes the virus makes them sick, but sometimes the birds don't get sick from the disease, but act as carriers of the virus. We've also seen this virus in mammals, such as foxes, minks, seals and sea lions, and most recently in cows in the US. In rare cases, people have also been infected when in contact with infected birds or mammals on contaminated environments.
So Wenqing, if human infections are so rare, why is WHO concerned about it?
So far, close to 900 human infections have been reported. Although the number may appear not as big as many other outbreaks, we need to bear into mind that each infection in human is an attempt of the virus to try to establish itself in human population. Although the chances are slim so far, as long as it succeeds once, just once, it is a start of an influenza pandemic, which can be as mild as the 2009 pandemic, but equally it also could be devastating like the 1918 one, also called the Spanish flu. That's why this meter, we are concerned about the avian influenza and are watching it very closely.
Talk to us about who is at risk of bird flu.
Anyone exposed to infected live or dead poultry or infected animals or contaminated environments such as live bird markets is at risk. Slaughtering, defeathering, handling carcasses, and prepare poultry for consumption, especially in household settings, are also risk factors. So if you are poultry farmer or have chickens in your backyard, you need to be aware that you are at potential risk of catching bird flu. With avian influenza detected in cows in the US recently, if you are a dairy worker, you also need to be aware that you are at a potential risk of catching bird flu.
Wenqing, we know that this virus is evolving constantly. Talk to us about how WHO is preparing countries for a possible pandemic.
The risk of an influenza pandemic is persistent and is being watched closely by a long-standing global system called the Global Influenza Surveillance and Response System, also called GISRIS. This system will rapidly detect an influenza pandemic virus once it enters into human population. And from there, it will trigger a series of response, including the development of laboratory diagnostics and vaccines. In addition, WHO will rapidly release a series of practical guidance to countries tailored to the specific pandemic response needs.
So that's why it's important to keep an eye on the virus to see how it's changing. Tell us, in case of an outbreak, which foods are safe to eat?
Avoid consuming raw milk, eggs, and meat. Make sure you consume pasteurized or properly boiled milk and slowly cooked eggs and meat. If you are handling raw products, make sure you wash your hands before and after and follow other good food safety practices. This is in fact outstanding advice with or without avian influenza because these practices protect you from many diseases.
So tell us what else the public needs to do in case of an outbreak to protect themselves.
Be vigilant, minimize contact with animals in areas affected with avian influenza. Avoid contact with surfaces contaminated with animal feces. Strictly avoid contact with dead or sick animals, including wild birds. Report dead animals or request their removal by contacting local authorities. And wash your hands frequently and thoroughly, especially after contact with animals and their environments.
Thank you, Wenqin. There you have it, Science in 5 today. Until next time then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.